Hi, my name is Yujahan, and the title for this presentation will be Home Automation Using IoT. In the proposed system, there's two main components. The first one is smart home system or product, and the second one will be home surveillance system or home security system. So for the smart home products, there will be smart lighting system. In the smart lighting system, there's a smart curtain and smart light bulb, and this will work concurrent with each other to provide the user with the best result. I will be further explaining on this in the upcoming slide. Secondly, will be the smart drying rack. So in the smart drying rack, for the smart drying rack, there will be a weather forecast for user to check for weather forecast before they dry their clothes or dry the laundry. As for the second component, the proposed system is the smart surveillance system. The smart surveillance system, there will be a smart lock which will utilize facial recognition technology to unlock the door, or in other words, you use facial recognition authentication to unlock the door. And with the camera on the smart lock, the user can also utilize the camera for as a security camera. Okay, comes to the problem statement. First of all, the existing lighting system. The problem with existing lighting system is it requires manual interaction, which means the user need to go to the panel to either turn on or turn off their light. Also, for most of the existing lighting system that's out in the market, usually they are fixed in brightness, which means the user doesn't have the flexibility to adjust the brightness. And then they are not environmental friendly, because if the user were to forget to turn off their light or they accidentally leave their light open, the user have to go to the panel. If they are not at home, they wouldn't be able to do that. And lastly would be for the existing lighting system out there, usually they are standalone for smart light and smart curtain. So for this, this is not cost effective or not cost is costly, because two standalone systems usually cost more. Second of all, for the existing drying rack, the problem is the same. Manual interaction is required. And also, after conducting research online, we found that increasing by drying clothes indoor, it will increase the indoor humidity by 30%, which is bad for people with lung condition, because it increases the chances of mold to grow. So this will also be bad for people with allergic. Okay, for the research objective, the first one is facial recognition using ESP32 cam. This is for the smart lock. So the main component for the smart lock is ESP32 cam, and facial recognition is the main technology to use to authenticate the user. Second of all is to integrate home security system and surveillance system into home automation system. So this will enable us to have a system, application to monitor and control both system. The thirdly is to automate home accessories with IoT motors and sensor. So as mentioned before, the smart home products, they are like traditional products. So by using the IoT motors and sensor, we'll be able to change them into smart product. So the limitation of the proposed project is facial recognition is still immature. It's a new technology, which is quite widely used now, but it's still is comparatively immature compared to other authentication methods such as fingerprint. The second of all is the proposed system is run on an Android platform, so the system is still unable to run on iOS devices, but that will be one of the future enhancements. Thirdly, will be integration. So there's a limited application programming interface, the API. So the smart weather API that is currently using for the Android apps will be not able to run on the other platform. So that's one of the limitation. The last one, as for the target audience, this product is suitable for all type of recommendation. For example, this product will be suitable for houses or even apartment or condo. Okay, as for the research review, after conducting research online, we found that according to David Delmise, a break in often cause result in an average loss of over $2,000. So it's best to invest in security system, because you cost less in the event of a break-in. Second of all, facial recognition are widely used to identify known criminals following the incident of 9/11. So facial recognition have been around since a long time. So it has been adapted by the people or the community. And I believe this will, facial recognition has started to turn into a main authentication for this generation of devices. And lastly is about biometric technologies such as fingerprint are widely used. So since biometric technology are widely used, any sort of smart lock the user will react positively towards this new technology of to authenticate the user. So after conducting review online, we found that the ADT home security system, which is widely used in Malaysia, they have started to switch to Android base as well. So from here we can see that people are starting to accepting the changes or the adoption of Android application. And second security system is the Paradox security system, which is also quite popular in Malaysia. They've also started to change or to adopt the Android application. And as for the smart home product, one of the most well-known smart home products in Malaysia or the smart home solution is the Wirox smart system engineer. So as we can, after conducting the research, we identified that the community is started to switching into smart home products or start to adopt smart home products. As for the research methodology the framework to be used to this project will be Spiral SDLC framework. This framework is a combination of waterfall and SDLC model. So it will be done in a structured way. So a Spiral SDLC framework is a repetitive process. So with every iteration, a new version will appear. So it is suitable for IoT project, because IoT project usually requires a lot of testing and prototyping, which means that a new version will be generated each time the framework has been finished. As for fact-finding techniques for this project, the first one will be questionnaire. The objective for questionnaire is a simple method to collect large amount of data. So for quantitative data, we will be using questionnaire and used to collect user opinion on smart home and smart surveillance system. So in the questionnaire, the user will be getting question relays to the smart home and smart surveillance system. So this is to study the feasibility of the proposed system to see whether the user react positively towards smart home or security system. As for the second fact-finding techniques, interviews the second fact-finding techniques. We use interview to get an in-depth opinion of existing smart home user. So by conducting interviews, you'll be able to get more in-depth information or opinion of the existing smart home user to better enhance the proposed system. And the second of all, for the interview, we also want to identify the existing home security or home surveillance user to identify the weakness and the strength of existing surveillance system to ensure the quality of the proposed system. So for the questionnaire summary, I have obtained the information to help identify user opinion on the feasibility of the proposed system. So yeah, second of all, to get user opinion on system design. So this is to verify is the system design identify the system design strength and weakness from the user point of view. So for the summary, getting from the respondents is they react positively and agree to give the system a try. As for the interview summary, some of the participants think that the existing home security or surveillance system doesn't suit their recommendation. For example, if they are living in a small apartment, to install a security system will be costly, and maybe they are renting a unit, so installing security system will be a hassle, and also it will restrict them to keep the existing the installed security system there, because it's hard to uninstall or bring the system to the next unit. So participants prefer to use smart lock with camera rather than install the existing security system. And lastly, the existing user suggests that the existing system lack of real-time monitoring and false alarm issue. So most of the participants think that the existing system lack of real-time monitoring. So maybe some of the users, they are having the old system which required physical access to the device, for example screen, to monitor the footage, the surveillance footage, and also they often get false alarm issue, for example stray cat running to the security system and causes false alarm. Okay, as for the system implementation, the development tools used is Android Studio IDE. The Android Studio IDE is used to develop the Android app to control and monitor the system, the proposed system. And the Arduino IDE is used to create and upload the code or the load to create and upload the code to the microcontroller, which will be based on Arduino. Second of all is the API use. The API use is the open weather app. So the open weather app provides forecast for the joint rack, as mentioned before. And as for the database, Firebase is used because Firebase is a real-time non-relational database, which means that the user can check for the update of their system or monitor their system at any time. And as for the non-relational database, is useful because the data are non-structured. So for the system implementation or the module use for this for the prototype, there's a few components. Firstly is the Arduino Uno R3, So Arduino Uno actually consists of a large amount of digital and analog pins. This will allow the author to create a prototype to automate their products, because there's a lot of pin. So the author will be able to use various sensor and motors. And second of all, the advantage of Arduino Uno R3 is low power consumption, which is environmental friendly and also cost effective. And second of all is the LDR light sensor. So LDR light sensor is actually stand for light dependent resistor. This will be used to create the prototype for the smart lighting system. Thirdly is a stepper motor. So a stepper motor is a motor that moves in two directions. The movement is very accurate. So it will be used for systems such as the curtain, which require accurate movement. So for IoT module part 2, the first one is breadboard. As for the prototype, no soldering is required, so breadboard is chosen. So by using breadboard, we can use the jumper cable to connect the motors and the microcontroller together. And second and fifth is the jumper cable. So the jumper cable is the one that allowed the connection to be made between the microcontroller and also the motor or sensors. And as for number six is servo motor. This is suitable for specific movement in a specific direction. For example, if for the smart lock, to unlock the door, the motor only need to move into direction to lock and unlock. So this will be a much more cost effective and much suitable products, a much suitable motor to use for the following scenario. Okay, for the seven item in the list will be DHC22 humidity and temperature sensor. So this is a sensor that provide the reading for humidity and temperature. DHC22 is chosen over the other DHC module, which is DHC11, is because DHC22 is more accurate. And lastly is the ESP32 cam. So the ESP32 cam will be used in the smart lock system. The ESP32 cam is a microcontroller with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. So this will enable the mobile phone to communicate with the system with the Wi-Fi features, which send data to the database. So with the data in the database, the user can monitor their system using Firebase data. And is the ESP32 cam also consists of a camera module, which enable the facial recognition technologies to be implemented. Okay, as for the system implementation logical view, so this is the smart driving rack logical view. Okay, firstly, there's a DHC22 heat and humidity sensor. So this will get the reading for the heat and the humidity of the clothes, so the user can identify the weather, can get a rough idea of the weather, and the humidity reading will provide the user with the ideas of the condition of their clothes. And the second of all is a motor. A motor is connected to control the giant rack. As for the smart lighting system, the logical view of the connection for the prototype is a connection is made between the microcontroller and also a light bulb. Or in the system, there's a field light bulb and also a LDR sensor. So the LDR sensor will adjust the lighting according to what the user need. So, yep. As for the smart lock, the logical view of the connection between the IoT module is from the ESP32 cam, the module will be connected to a FTTI programmer. This is to allow the code to be run into the ESP32 cam. So the code will upload from FTTI programmer into ESP32 cam so the user can control, so the user can get the facial recognition technologies. And a connection will also be made between the ESP32 cam and the Arduino Uno by using the communication, the serial communication from ESP32 cam and Arduino Uno. The smart lock can unlock and lock the door using the servo motor, which turns into the action. Okay, now let's come to the system prototype. Okay, for the system flow, in the first page is the login page. So before the user need to proceed to use the system, they have to do a login. If the user doesn't have the credential, they can use the register features, which will bring the user here to the register page. So the user need to enter their email and the password and confirm password to register. So once the user is logged in, they'll be greeted by this interface, which will greet the user by their email address, and the user can also log out using the log out button. So in the home page, there's also two button which will bring the user to the smart home feature, which is the first component, and also the smart security features, which is the second component. For the smart dragging rack, this is the prototype, and to use the smart dragging rack, this the user can deliver it to the smart home homepage. In the smart home homepage, the smart dragging status is presented here, so the user can check for the weather forecast. If the user want to dry their clothes, the user can check for the weather forecast to check if the weather is suitable for drying clothes. And second of all is the sensor report. So the for example, if the weather forecast showed that there's today sunny and the sensor report also is also reporting sunny, so it means that there's a low chance that the clothes it will be raining, so it's more suitable to dry the clothes. And it also allowed the automation features. So for example, if the weather forecast is showing raining and here is showing sunny, based on the condition, driving clothes is not recommended. So yep, the user can decide on that. Or better yet, the user can navigate to the smart rack feature here. So the user can choose between these three options. The user can choose whether to automate, which allows the system to automatically extend and retract the drying rack to dry the clothes, or the user can manually extend or retract based on the weather forecast. As for the smart lighting system, so once if the user were to want to use the smart lighting system, the user can go to the smart light page in the previous screen. So here the user can go to the smart light page, and then here the user can adjust the brightness according to what they want, how bright they want the system to be. So by setting the brightness, the user can choose to automate. For example, if the user choose between 65%, so the outdoor LDR sensor, which will be installed outside the home, the sensor will check for the outside brightness to check if that meets the brightness that the user want. If that's the brightness that the user want, the stepper motor will push the curtain, so the light can enter the room. But for example, if the light outdoor is lower than what the user want, the curtain will close and the LED will turn on. So the indoor LDR will measure the brightness coming from the LED and adjust accordingly to brighten and soften the light to the user configuration according to the user configuration. So lastly, with the smart lock. So in the smart lock, the user can enroll their face. So by enrolling their face, the user will be able to utilize the smart lock for authentication. So when the user approaches the door, the smart lock will be unlocked. So to unlock the smart door, the thermal motor is used. So if, for example, the user is detected as a user, the smart lock will turn into one direction, so the door will be unlocked, so the user can enter the door. For facial detection, so if this feature is turned on, the user can use the smart lock. If the feature is turned off, for example, if the user at home, they can use their phone just to check the video footage without the facial recognition technology. And the get stop streaming, this feature is to turn off the system, so the system can be turned off for both the surveillance and also the smart authentication for the smart lock. So here the user can also take a photo of the front door. So for example, if someone not at the front door, user can take a photo of them, and the user can check at the cam lock or the check photo option down here, which will bring the user to the cam lock, so the user can check who is at the front door, and the user can approach the front door to unlock the door, or the user can take a screenshot of the photo and keep it as a proof. Maybe the user suspect that the person at the front door is trying to break in. Yep. So the prototype view is this is the ESP32 cam, and this is the camera module. So by using this camera module, we can do the facial recognition, also the surveillance. Yep. Thank you for watching the presentation, and I'll end this video now.